My name is Twyla Braze, I'm President of Citizens Council on Healthcare, and we have long been opposed to the Obamacare bill, and so it's no surprise that we would be opposed to attempts to conform Minnesota law to the bill. If you have further, because testimony is of course limited, if you want to know further the provisions that we are opposed to, you can go to our website, which is healthcarefreedom.us, and you can see much more of what we have done to this date. And just as there are many of us here in this room that oppose, that came here today to oppose conforming Minnesota law to Obamacare, and I don't know if you can see them, but everyone can raise your hand who's here to do that. And a lot of them have left because it's taken so long to get to this point in the testimony, but you can see there's a lot of people. One thing I just want to ask from you, Mr. Chair, is that you have the bill here. There are a lot of people who wanted to testify and didn't have the opportunity. You have the bill listed, but of course it's not a hearing on the bill. Is there a time where people who are concerned, who wanted to testify, will be able to testify in the bill that was conformed our law?
Yeah, we were not going to vote today, and there will be, if we decide to move forward with that bill, there will have to be hearings.
Right. Thank you, Mr. Chair. Well, clearly we're concerned about making Obamacare the law of the land here in Minnesota, and I'll give you just 5 reasons why. Number one, because it violates the United States Constitution, the new federal law imposes an individual mandate requiring citizens to purchase health insurance or face fines and perhaps jail time. This is unconstitutional. If the federal government can twist the Commerce Clause to regulate the non-purchase of something, there is no limit to what it can require each of us to buy. Number two, the federal law requires the expansion of Medicaid. This is a high-cost, unfunded mandate on taxpaying Minnesotans who are already suffering under higher costs and reduced incomes. The state of Minnesota is also facing a huge deficit, as we all know. It requires a balanced budget, and it cannot print money, therefore making it very difficult to accept this provision of the federal law. Number three, Obamacare is a clear indication that Congress and President Obama intend to usurp the role of state legislators, relegating you all, potentially, to being mere regulators of federal policies and following what they say that you must do. And we call on you as state legislators to stand up, as many states have done with the Real ID law, and to say no to Washington. Number four, the federal law will lead to higher health care costs. For instance, the $13 billion prevention trust fund. The CBO says that the preventive care will increase utilization and spending. So it's going to be higher costs no matter how much you think that prevention is going to decrease costs. But they also have said that there will be increased premiums, particularly on individuals and on young people. The fact that the federal government is forecasting billions in revenue for failure to comply with the insurance mandate also should show you how unaffordable health insurance is expected to become. And number five, Obamacare will discourage citizens from becoming doctors. It sets into place onerous command and control systems allowing federal officials to define what medical care is considered effective and what medical care is considered fraud, waste, and abuse. Not only in public programs, but in private insurance, therefore putting federal agents in all of our private insurance plans and in all our private medical decisions between patients and doctors. And what if the care that you need or one of your constituents needs is arbitrarily defined as ineffective and wasteful? As New York Senator Chuck Schumer said on Meet the Press 2 Sundays ago, if doctors give quantity and not quality, they will be disciplined. Well, the term quality has never been defined in a way that anybody could understand it or clearly know what that is. But quality can be whatever the government wants it to be, including following government treatment protocols that ration or deny care. After all, they have to take that $500 billion out of Medicare, and they're going to do it, taking it from patients. And you might want to ask, what kind of discipline is planned for doctors who treat patients as unique individuals, as patients are? In conclusion, it's a sworn obligation of every state legislator and every elected officer to uphold the United States Constitution, to protect the sovereign rights of individuals under the Constitution, and to prevent the federal government from usurping states' rights as protected under the 10th Amendment. So instead of conforming to Obamacare, I'm asking you on behalf of all the concerned individuals in this room and around the state to find every possible way to say no to Obamacare in Minnesota. Thank you.
Representative Rubin.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Thank you, Ms. Grace. I'm just wondering, is it your opinion that if we do nothing, that your premiums won't go up, or our premiums won't go up, or health care costs won't go up?
Ms. Grace.
Mr. Chair and Representative Rood, I think it's that everybody is in agreement that something must happen, but what we believe should happen is that a market should take a place, should take place. And a market is not what we have today, even with the health plan. In fact, a market is when you put the money in the hands of individuals, and particularly if you move to more real insurance rather than prepaid health care as we have today, and give individuals their money back to make the decisions that work for them. You will increase the cost consciousness that everybody talks about that every individual needs. But while somebody else is paying the bill, we don't even have negotiations. We have doctors who don't know what anything costs, and therefore the bill can keep going up.
Any other questions? I don't see any, so the meeting is adjourned.
Oh, wait a minute. We have time. Okay, we have half hour.